Hello students, welcome to the new discussion on engineering mechanics. I am Gayatri Mavre, assistant professor at engineering sciences department, AISSMS IOIT Pune. Today we will see ladder friction and we will solve practice questions on ladder friction. Ladder is a structure used for climbing or scaling on the walls or roofs. In the absence of friction, ladder will slide down and fall on the floor. The upper end of a ladder tends to slide down and lower end moves away from the wall. Steps to solve problems of ladder friction are: first, draw FBD of given ladder and then use equations of equilibrium, summation moment about any point equals to zero, summation fx equals to zero and summation fy equals to zero for finding out unknowns. Here, two ladders are shown. For first picture, ladder of L length is placed against wall and a floor such that it is making angle theta with respect to horizontal. If end A of the ladder is resting against floor like this, there will be contact reaction for point A directed from the floor towards the ladder. As this is end A of the ladder, we can name this reaction as NA. Similarly, for B end of the ladder, which is in contact with the vertical wall, contact reaction NB will act from the wall towards the ladder. Weight of ladder will act from its center vertically downward. And as μs is given, that is coefficient of static friction is mentioned for floor, there will be friction force acting between ladder and the floor. We can call this as friction force for end A, for surface A, FR, A. Arrow direction for friction force will be away from the wall because friction is always opposite to the direction of possible motion. And if this ladder sleeps, its A end will try to go away from wall, and that's why friction force must be directed like this, opposite to the direction of possible motion. For B end, if the wall is rough, then friction force will act parallel to the contact surface and its direction will be like this because B end will try to slide down. As motion is in downward direction, so friction force will be opposite to it, that is vertically upward. In the second picture, this ladder is making theta angle with vertical. So with horizontal, it will make 90 minus theta angle. This angle will be 90 minus theta. For B end, if this slide moves, if this slide slips, then direction of motion is towards right and therefore friction force will be like this towards left. And for A end, if this ladder slips, A end will move down and the friction force will be vertically upward. This is friction force for A point. Let us try to solve one problem. Draw FBD of ladder as shown in figure below. So here, one ladder of 15 meter length is resting against wall with angle theta with respect to horizontal. Say weight of the ladder is W. So it will act from its center vertically downward. This is weight of ladder W. At A point, normal reaction NA will act from the surface towards the ladder. For B point, normal reaction will be horizontal. From wall towards ladder. Friction force for end A will be parallel to the contact surface. Now, if this ladder slips, the direction of motion for end A is away from the wall like this. So the friction force for end A will be opposite to the direction of possible motion. This is friction force for point A or surface A. Friction force for vertical wall. This is direction of motion of ladder. And therefore, friction force at contact surface B will be vertically upward. And we can call this as FB, friction force for contact surface B. This is how we can draw FBD of given ladder. No other externally applied force is acting on ladder. No thread or spring is attached to the ladder. So this is FBD of given ladder. Let us try to solve one practice problem of ladder friction. The uniform pole of length L and mass M is leaned against the vertical wall as shown in figure below. If the coefficient of static friction between supporting surfaces and the ends of the pole is 0.25. So here, this is coefficient of static friction, that is mu s. Mu s is given 0.25 for all contact surfaces. Calculate the maximum angle theta at which the pole may be placed before it starts to slip. So very first step to solve problems of ladder friction is to draw its FBD. Draw ladder as it is, make it free from its surrounding. Weight of ladder will act vertically downward. For floor B, normal reaction NB is vertically upward. Normal reaction NA is from the wall towards the ladder. Now, friction force for surface B is opposite to the direction of possible motion. And if ladder slips, this B end of a ladder will go away from wall like this. So friction force FRB is opposite to the direction of possible motion. Same is the case with friction force for surface A. Here, if ladder slips, its A end will go down. This is direction of possible motion. So friction force is vertically upward. This is complete FBD of given ladder. Now use three equations of equilibrium one by one to find out unknowns. Summation Fx equals to zero. If I write for this FBD given, then plus Na, this is horizontal force, minus FRB. This is second horizontal force and its summation is equals to zero. It gives me Na equals to FRB. Now, as this is friction force for surface B, we can write friction force as mu N. Mu is 0.25, so this is mu NB. And rearranging the terms, I get NB is equals to 4 times of Na. Now, next, use other equations of equilibrium. That is, summation Fy equals to zero. Now, in this FBD, collect all vertical forces. Friction force at A point is mu Na, that is 0.5 Na, which is vertically upward, so written positive here. This is friction force at A point minus weight plus NB. This is equals to zero. Now 0.25 Na plus MG is equals to 4 Na. NB is equals to 4 Na. This we have finded out from summation Fx equals to zero. So put this NB equals to 4 Na and take MG on other side. So we get that 4.25 Na is equals to MG. Here we have value of MG in terms of Na. Use third equation of equilibrium, that is summation MB equals to zero. We are trying to take moment about point B, which is here. So moment because of FRB and NB will be zero. Let us write down moment of Na force about point B. So Na is a force into distance of this force from point B. This total vertical distance is equals to L cos theta, because theta angle I have written here. This is angle theta and length of the ladder is L. So this vertical distance will be if I draw a right angle triangle here, then in this right angle triangle, vertical distance will be L cos theta. Now this Na will rotate about point B in clockwise sense, like this, clockwise sense. So I have written minus sign for the moment. Next, moment because of MG force is MG into now distance of this vertical force from B point, perpendicular distance will be this horizontal distance, and it is equals to L by 2 sine theta, because angle here also is theta. So the distance will be L by 2 sine theta. Now mg will rotate about point B in anti-clockwise sense, so plus sine. Next is moment because of friction force FRA. So FRA we have written as 0.25 Na into distance of this vertical force from B point is this total horizontal distance, which is L sine theta. And this FRA force will rotate about point B in clockwise sense like this. That's why minus sine for the moment. Now do the calculations and take L common so that we can cancel L from both sides, rearrange the terms, and we get that tan theta is equals to 0.533. So theta is equals to 28.07. It means when angle theta of the ladder with respect to vertical is 28.07, then this ladder will not sleep, but it will be on the verge of sleeping. In this lecture, we have seen ladder friction and we have solved practice questions on ladder friction. This is time to check your understanding. Here is one question. Determine smallest angle theta, where theta is shown with respect to horizontal, at which the ladder can be placed against the side of smooth wall. Wall is smooth. It means friction force for the wall we need not to consider. Without having it sleep, take coefficient of static friction at 0.25. You can solve this question and match your answers with theta equals to 63.43. This is end of the lecture. Thank you.